The great majority of the poorest countries lie in the geographical tropics, the area between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. In contrast, most of the richest countries lie in the temperate zones. Among the 28 economies categorized as a high income by the World Bank, with population of at least 1 million, only Hong Kong, Singapore, and part of Taiwan are in the tropical zone, representing a mere 2% of the combined population of the high-income regions. Almost all temperate zone countries have either high-income economies, as in the cases of North America, Western Europe, Korea, and Japan, or middle-income economies burdened by socialist policies in the past, as in the case of Eastern Europe, the former Soviet Union, and China. In addition, there is a strong temperate tropical divide within countries that straddle both types of climates. Most of Brazil, for example, lies within the tropical zone, but the richest part of the nation, the southernmost states, is in the temperate zone. Historically, the civilization was centered around warm tropics and subtropics. The first five civilizations, Samur, Nile Valley, Indus Valley, Yellow River Valley, and North Echiku, were all in subtropics. The ones that followed, in Greece, Persia, Rome, were in the same zone too. Subtropics often were better than tropics because the latter was often next to dense rainforests with wildlife and epidemic dangers. Still, the warmer regions performed better throughout history. Colonialism changed this dynamic for the first time. The cold weather regions have very low population density, as not many people preferred cold winters. This allowed the farmers to have much larger lands and more potential mines and mineral resources. Until the modern era, these were hard to tap though. Since the colder countries had to trade with the warmer, they developed their sea routes, which made them develop coordination, bravery, and foremost, sustainability in their cargo and naval ships. When industrial revolution came, the technology desperately helped those in cold climates. Mechanized farming, tractors, and other machines allowed industrial-scale farming over those lands. This allowed the farmers to get rich because they had now huge lands that could be fully tapped. Factories also could now go to minerals, resources, and infrastructure as large parts of their countries were sparsely occupied. In contrast, industrial revolution could not do much to densely populated tropics that already had high farming productivity but shared by a large number of farmers. Tropics were too densely populated, meaning lesser resources and lesser room or infrastructure. Before industrial revolution, there were very less population in these places. Less population is easy to manage. Hence, infrastructure was built in very well planned way. However, Asian countries building new infrastructure was nightmare. Other factor you can consider is migration. Migration enabled them entry of highly skilled laborers and research schoolers. However, industrial revolution was completely went against old labor-based economy. They poorly killed all the handcrafting market, clothes, farming, and business of India and China. Other aspect colonialism did that to open up huge markets. England had a small domestic market, population was small, but through its colonies, it got a huge market for its textile mills and industries. In earlier times, there was not much international trade, and those in sparsely populated regions could not benefit from their innovations. Most of developed countries are cold in winter, but have comfortable, mild temperatures over large areas for most seasons through the year. Example of comfortable temperature, usually from 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. Those are good temperature for anything, working, studying, thinking, working out, even for sleeping. That is pretty much like living under natural AC. The cold fresh air replenishes your stamina. On the other hand, warmer countries, which usually have temperatures from about 28 to 37 degrees Celsius or even more, are harder to work on. They usually have blazing suns and might as well have really high levels of humidity, making it very uncomfortable to do anything like working out and studying. And if it is a hot night, it can even uncomfortable to sleep, to rest. Working under the harsh sun can feel almost unbearable. The heat in the environment makes it easy to overheat and eats away your stamina. Unlike cold, you can deal with it by putting on more clothes. In the 21st century, we are entering a post-industrial era and the pendulum might be shifting again. Mines and lands are not as important as they were in the, say, 20th century. It is about the number of mines networked. In this, the subtropics, tropics such as California, Singapore or Shanghai are getting back in the game. The size of domestic markets matters big once again. California startups could attest, and density helps in various other ways too for an information economy. Despite their varied economic, political and social histories, almost all of the tropical countries remain underdeveloped at the start of the 21st century. Only two tropical zone countries, Hong Kong and Singapore, ranks among the 30 countries classified as high income by the World Bank. All of the high income regions, North America, Western Europe, Northeast Asia, the southern cone of Latin America and Oceania, are outside the tropics. When temperate zone economies are not rich, there is typically a straightforward explanation, such as decades under communism. And sea navigator regions are generally richer than landlocked nations. If you like the video, give it a like and subscribe, and hit the notification bell so YouTube notifies you when I upload a new video. Thanks.